corruptible material things. Well, that's what we were bought. That's why he says we were bought with the precious blood of Jesus. The precious blood of Christ bought us. I mean, that's how valuable you are. More valuable than all the riches of this world. Amen. You're more valuable than that. I mean, that's awesome when you think about it. You know, it doesn't have anything to do with who you are. You know, your station in life or your status in life. It doesn't have anything to do with what you've done. Because simply God so loved the world. That's made up of all different kinds of people. Good people, bad people.
Amen.
People that do good things, people that do bad things. People that say good things and say bad things. You know, that. And everybody is included in that. He loves the whole world so much that he bought us with his precious blood.
Amen.
So it doesn't matter who you are. Doesn't matter what you've done. You know, you could be you might be a thief, a liar, a cheater, a drunkard, a drug abuser, a gossiper, mean to people, sexually immoral, and you feel worthless. Doesn't matter. God thinks you're valuable.
Amen.
You may be a victim of someone else, a victim in one of these areas in your life at the hands of someone else, and you feel worthless. Doesn't matter. It does matter, you know, things happen, but it doesn't matter as far as your value to God. God thinks you're valuable no matter what. Maybe you're somebody who's poor and you think you're worthless. Money and things have nothing to do with your value to God. Nothing to do with it. You may be well off or wealthy, materialistic, and think you're a big shot. You got it all together. And yet still somehow you think you're just not quite good enough. You got to go get more. No, I'm here to say you're good enough right where you are, no matter what. Rich or poor, young or old, black or white, green or yellow, doesn't matter. Male or female, it doesn't matter to God. You are valuable.
Amen.
They probably can hear me in the kitchen, man, yelling so loud. Praise the Lord. All right. I get excited. But, I mean, I think about, you know, my life. You can think about your life. You mean God thinks I'm valuable? Yes.
Amen.
After what I've done or not done or where I've come from or where I've been or all that, yes, he still thinks you're valuable. No matter what your station is in life, no matter where you are. You may just be an ordinary person with just an ordinary amount of, you know, average self-esteem. Just kind of a normal, you know, what the world thinks of as a normal. You know? No highs, no lows, just kind of cruising kind of person. You know what I'm trying to get at? You know, not the extreme one way or the other.
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of the average person. Well, God still thinks you're valuable. You're not just average to him. You're not just, you know, regular to him. You're valuable.
Amen.
Very valuable, profitable, useful, and costly, and precious, and dear, and highly esteemed. And high priced, very high priced, his blood.
Amen.
Was the price he paid. And very high esteemed by God. How do we know that? Well, Romans 5:8. God demonstrated his love for us in that while we are yet sinners, Christ died for us. I mean, when you're willing to give your life for someone, that means you think they're pretty valuable, right?
Amen.
I'm going to close in Ephesians 2. Ephesians 2, you know, because some may ask, how can God love and value me? Why would God want to have anything to do with me? I don't amount to anything. I'm just a nothing. You know, Pastor, you don't know where I came from. I do know where you came from. I know where I came from. We all came from the same place. Did you know that?
Amen.
As far as we came from the same level in the eyes of God. We came from the same place, and Ephesians 2 tells us what we came from. And that what God thinks of us in spite of where we came from. Ephesians 2, verse 1, it says, And you he made alive who were dead in trespasses and sins, in which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience, among whom we all once conducted ourselves in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, just as others. I know that description sounds like, oh my gosh, I was a terrible, you're saying I was a terrible person like that, Pastor? I'm not saying anything, I'm just reading it.
Amen.
Okay? And, you know, it doesn't, you know, some people do what we think of as higher degrees or, you know, lesser degrees of bad and good and sin and, you know, stuff and all of that. We try to put, you know, levels on it and value on it. And, you know, and I understand some things are, you know, worse than, you know, stealing a pencil is not, maybe not quite as bad as killing somebody, but it's still bad. Come on.
Mm.
It's still stealing, right?
That's right?
It's still bad. It's not maybe at the same level of badness, but you know, that's not the point. The point is we were all bad somehow.
That's right.
We were all born into this world. We were born in sin. It says here we were dead in our trespasses and sins. Because of sin, no matter if it was a little sin or a big sin, it's still the same result. Spiritual death. On your way to eternal death, if something doesn't change.
Right.
But God changed that. It says, you he made alive. So, he tells us where he found us. It says that he found us dead in our trespasses and sins. You can follow along there. He found us walking according to the course of this world. You know, just walking the way the world walks. Sound familiar? Come on.
Yep.
He found us walking according to the ways of the devil and disobedient spirits, whether consciously or unconsciously. People do it. He found us living by the lusts of our flesh and the lusts of our mind. You know, the lust there, it's kind of a strong word, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't just mean, you know, sexually. Yes, you can say sex in church. Somebody said that last week. Yeah. And
point,
look at Tom. Lust includes a lot more than that. You know, lust, the word lust simply means an over desire.
Mm-hmm.
People lust after money. People lust after food. People lust after power.
Mm-hmm.
People can lust after a lot of things, including that one three-letter word that I will not repeat, Todd. But he found us lust, living by the lusts of our flesh and the lusts of our mind. He found us, it says there, as children of wrath. And then verse 4, it says, but God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It doesn't sound good reading those first three verses until you get to the first couple words of the next verse. But God, in spite of all that, he found us one way, but didn't leave us that way.
Amen.
But God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in trespasses, made us alive with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up together, and made us sit together in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. I mean, we got elevated to a high position. You know, people in high position, you know, kingdoms or whatever, people in high position, they're usually more valuable, worldly speaking, kind of people, right?
Right.
We think of them that way. But God lifted us all to that level of value. Come on.
Amen.
He lifted us all to that level of value. Why? Because of his great mercy and because of his great love wherewith he loved us. Even, it says, even when we were in that state of life, which wasn't life, it was death.
Mm-hmm.
Dead in our trespasses and sins. Even when we were in that state, he said, he raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ. Amen. So that's good news. God doesn't just leave me as he finds me. He doesn't leave you as he finds you. No. He does something about you. He makes available a way out for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
See, God finds you one way, but because of his mercy and his great love and his wonderful grace, He has value. He values you.
Amen.
And saves you. You know, that's what you keep reading on there. For by grace you're saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it's the gift of God, not of works. He values you so much, he doesn't even make you work hard for it.
Amen.
The work is receiving his love, receiving his grace, and believing on Jesus Christ by faith.
Amen.
Now, I'm not saying that there's no work involved after that. Because I believe in Christ, I'm not afraid to get busy. Come on.
Because you love him.
That's right, because I love him. My wife loves me, and so she does things for me. I love my wife, so I go do things for her.
That's right, you
do. I went to $2 stores last night for her. That's all, I'll tell you that.
He did.
She wanted these stupid little trays, the little plastic, well, they're stupid to me. Not to her. They were something. Sorry, honey. She wanted these little trays, and she told me right where to find them. She said, as long as you're going out, and I went to put up the church signs and stuff, as long as you're going out, would you stop and get me those? That would be really great. And so I stopped at the one, and they had one tray left of the one size. She wanted two sizes. They had one package left of each or something like that, just not nearly what she wanted. And I thought, okay, what do I do? I know she loves me, and she'd just say, that's okay, you tried. But let me drive to find another one and see what I can do. Now that's love. Now you think, you know, that's nothing compared to the love God has for you and I, right?
Amen.
Nothing compared to how much he loves us. I mean,
amen.
That's how valuable we are to him. He's willing to go through whatever it takes. He already did it. And what does he do? Because of his love and mercy, because of, you know, his grace. What is grace? When you get something you don't deserve? Is that the way it is?
Yeah.
God gives you something you don't deserve. God's riches at Christ's expense. What's that called?
Grace.
I know, but what's that called? It's a word for what? What?
Acronym?
An acronym or something. I don't know what they call them. See, God can use anybody. You usually don't know what that is. But God gives us what we don't, even what he gives us, you know, better than we ever could deserve.
Amen.
Through our faith in Jesus Christ. Why? Because we're valuable. Amen.
Amen.
He finds us one way, but he doesn't leave us that way if we'll only open our hearts to him.
Amen.
Open your heart to Jesus, and your life will never be the same.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's bow our heads. Father, thank you for your word.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, that you do love us.
Yes.
And you do value each and every one of us, Lord. Lord, I pray that each one here today, each one watching, each one hearing this, Lord, will get a better grasp and an understanding and a assurance, Lord, of the value that you put upon each and every one of us.
Yes.
And Lord, I just pray that if there's any that don't know you, that they've not received your love and mercy and grace, they've not put their trust in you, that they'll do that now. They'll call upon Jesus Christ and be saved. Say, Jesus, save me. Be my Lord and my Savior. I give my life and my heart to you. I'm yours from this moment forward. I believe that you died and rose again to save me from all of my sins. And I receive your forgiveness. Thank you for giving me eternal life. I'm yours. Pray a prayer. If you prayed that prayer or pray a prayer similar, just giving your heart to him, committing yourself to him. He receives that, and he receives you.
Yes.
And you become qualified.
Amen.
For everything, all the good he's looking to do. His eyes are running to and fro looking. He wants to keep on. He wants to keep on doing you good.
Amen.
Amen. Let's pray. Over. Before we do, I just want to say that if you, we're about to pray the blessing over you or speak the blessing over you, but there's anything that you would like us to pray with you about, we're available. There's others here available. You can, if you're watching by Facebook, you can message through there or through the website. You can send, contact us that way. The contact information is there. All of that, we'd love to be able to be part of God working in your life, and I know He will if you reach out to Him.
Amen.
So let's receive the blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you, look upon you with His favor, and give you peace.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you.
Amen. God bless you. Amen. Hallelujah.